Hi friends, good morning to all of you. Today we continue our lesson Reproduction in Plants of class 5 science. Now in previous class we have studied about reproduction. We have already studied about what do we mean by the term reproduction. Now we study that plants reproduce in two ways. Some plants reproduce through seeds, some plants reproduce through stems, leaves and roots. Therefore, seeds is a type of sexual reproduction. Because seeds are formed after sexual reproduction in flowers of plant. That's why seeds comes in the category of sexual reproduction. But stem, leaves and roots, this is come in the category of asexual reproduction. So one by one we will study about these two types of reproduction. Now, before this, I would like to explain some terms about seeds. So, seeds are product of sexual reproduction in flowers of plant. Flowers of plant. That's why seed is very important in reproduction. Now, okay, seed have three basic parts in form. Number first is seed coat or seed coat, or sometimes it's called leaflet. There is another name for, but it will discuss in next class. Now the second part is the angiosperm. It is also called cotyledons. Now the third part is embryo. Three basic parts in common. First is the seed coat, second is the endosperm, or sometimes it's called cotyledons. And the third part is the embryo or the baby plant. So, I'm going to draw a diagram of seed. So here we see that सीड को दिस पार्ट इज नोन एज एम्ब्रियो एंड दिस इज नोन एज द कोटिलेडन्स इज नोन एज द कोटिलेडन्स. सो द मेन फंक्शन ऑफ सीड कोट इज सीड गिव्स प्रोटेक्शन टू द एम्ब्रियो. द सेकेंड फंक्शन the function of endosperm or the cotyledons is the cotyledons or the endosperm gives nutrition to the embryo. The function of embryo or baby plant is it is the premature or the initial in a stage, it is in a dormant stage. This is the baby plant which are in here it is in dormant stage. Which favorable condition if it receives proper amount of sunlight, water and all the essential nutrients, then it becomes a new plant.
Ready.
Now on the basis of cotyledons, seeds are of two types. First is the monocotyledons, second is the dicotyledons. Mono means one, those type of seeds which contain only one cotyledons are said to be monocotyledons, and those type of seeds which contain two cotyledons are called dipods or dicotyledons. It is also called monopods. It is also called dipods. So examples are wheat. Wheat, rice, and maize. In dicotyledons, examples are beans, peas, and pulses. These are the examples of dicotyledons and monocotyledons. So, in next video, we will study about seed dispersal and what are the factors which affect the seed dispersal. So, thank you.